Hello everyone, here we'll be taking up a few questions in exercise 6.3 of chapter Squares and Square Roots in your class 8th NCERT book. Coming on to the first question. First question asks us to find the possible ones digits of the square root of the given numbers. So here a number is given to us. We need to tell them that what is the possible ones digit when this number's square root is taken. So for this I see that we have four parts in this question. Part 1 and part 3, the solution of these two parts will be same because both these numbers have 1 present at the units place. So I'll be solving them together. Also, there is a list given here wherein I can see that when I square 1, I get 1. When I square 2, I get 4 and so on. So I can see the units places of the squared numbers and I find that 1 can be obtained when either 1 is squared or 9 is squared. So I can see from this chart very clearly that for a number when squared to result in a number that will have 1 at the units place, it is important for that number to have either 1 or 9 at its units place. So what I can say, I can simply say that the possible units digits or the ones digits of the root of this number will either be 1 or 9. Now next, coming on to the second part of the first question, I see I have 6 present at the units place. And also I can see from here, this chart here, that when 4 is squared, I can get 6 at the units place. Or when 6 is squared, I can get 6 at the units place. I can say that the ones place digit, when the square root of this number is taken, is either 4 or 6. Coming on to the fourth part, I see that I have 5 here and from the list I can check that when 5 is squared, I get 5 at the units place. So I can say that the possible ones digit of the square root of this number is 5. Now coming on to the second type of the questions, that is the second question in this exercise. We need to find the numbers which are surely not perfect squares. For this, we should know that for a number to be a perfect square, it should either have 1 present at the units place, or 4, or 5, or 6, or 9, or even number of zeros in the end. So if it has 2, 3, 7, 8, or odd number of zeros in the end, we can say that these numbers are not perfect squares. So let us check the units place digit. We see that we have 3 here. Also, we see from this list here that when 3 is present at the units place, the number is not a perfect square. So this is surely not a perfect square. Now we have 257, 7 is present at the units place. Again, from the list, we can see that when 7 is present, we do not have a perfect square. 408, 8 is present at the units place. And from the list, it's very clear that when we have 8 at the units place, the number is not a perfect square. Now we have fourth part, 441. We have 1 present at the units place. Here we see that 1 is present here also. And when a number is squared, when either 1 was squared, we were getting 1. Or when 9, when a number that has 9 in its units place was being squared, we were getting 81 or 1 at the units place. So we can say that 441 is a perfect square. Now we have the third type of questions. Here we need to find the square root of the given numbers by the method of repeated subtraction. Now, what is this method? So we have two numbers given to us. One is 100, the other is 169. We need to find the square roots of these numbers by this method of repeated subtraction. So to apply this method, we must remember these steps here. Whatever number is given to us, we will subtract from that number the first odd number and we'll get something. Now whatever we've got here, again from this number we'll subtract the second odd number and again we'll get something. What is first odd number? First odd number is 1. Second odd number is 3. Similarly, third odd number will be 5. Fourth odd number will be 7, and so on. Now, whatever I have got here, this again will be taken, and from this I'll be subtracting the third odd number and I'll get something. Say, till this step I reach a level where the result is 0. I subtracted this orange box number, whatever it is. From this, I subtracted the third odd number and the result I'm getting is 0. Now I'll count the number of steps that I have gone through to reach this step that is equal to 0. And I see that I have gone through step 1, 2 and 3. So there are 3 steps that I'm taking and reaching a level where I get 0. So the square root of this number is equal to the number of steps that I have taken to reach 0. Finding the square root of 100 and 169, I proceed together. I subtract from 100 and from 169 the first odd number. So when I subtract first odd number from 100, I get 99. And from 169, I'm subtracting the first odd number, I'm getting 168. Next, I subtract from the result, that is, from 99, I'll be subtracting the second odd number, that is 3. I get 96. And same thing I'm doing with the other number also. Next, I take 96 again and I subtract 5, that is a third odd number, and I get 91. Same thing is being followed for the other number, that is 169. Next, the result was 91. So I'm taking this 91 and subtracting from this 91 the fourth odd number, and I get 84. Similarly, I'm doing for other steps also. Next step, I'm subtracting the fifth odd number and I get 75. From 75, I subtract the sixth odd number, that is 11. So I get 64. Now from 64, I'm subtracting the seventh odd number, that is 13, and I'm getting 51. And so on. I keep on doing these steps till I reach a level where I get 0. So you see here, I've reached a level 0 for 100. And there are still a few steps to be followed for 169 so that I reach 0. So I'll keep on doing and I'll reach a step 0 in this step here. I'll count the steps that I have taken to reach 0 for both the numbers. So I find that for 100, I'm taking 10 steps to reach 0 here. So I can say the square root of 100 is 10. And for 169, I'm taking a few more steps, that is a total of 13 steps. So I will write the root of 169 equal to 13. Now coming on to the fourth question in this exercise, again we are supposed to find the square roots only, but by the use of prime factorization method. Now what is this method? This method is simply where we write the given number in the form of the smallest possible factors or the prime factors. So 729 can be written as 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Next step, once when we've written this in the form of its prime factors, the second step is to take the square root on both the sides of this equation. So this sign will be inserted here. Next step is to make pairs of numbers within the root sign. So I can write 3, 3 together. I have marked it. Next 3, 3 will again be marked together. And next pair also I'm making. Now the third step. Third step is to write one number of these pairs out of the root sign. So I write the three threes outside the root sign and inside the root, I will be left with one, and root one is equal to one only. So I can simply write this. Now 3 into 3 into 3 is 27. So root 729 is equal to 27. Next, I come on to 400. I write it in the form of its prime factors and I get this. Next step, I take this square root on both the sides. Third step, I make pairs of the numbers inside the root sign that I have. Next step is to write one number from these pairs out of the root sign. So I can write 2 into 2 into 5 outside the root sign. And I see that the value of 2 into 2 into 5 is 20. So root 400 is 20. Now next number, again I'm writing in the form of the prime factors. First step, second step, I take the square root. Third step, I make pairs. When I make pairs of the numbers, 2 into 2 inside the root, it can be written as 2 outside the root. 3 into 3, it can be written as 3 outside the root. 7 into 7, it can be written as 7 outside the root. Next, I solve this value and I see that 2 into 3 into 7 gives me 42. So root 1764 is equal to 42. Next number also, I'll follow the same steps. I'll write the number in the form of its prime factors. Then I take the square root. Then I simply form pairs of these numbers and I see that 6 twos, or the 6 pairs of twos, are possible. So 1, 2 from each pair can be written outside the root sign. So I've done that and the value I get is 64. Now next, I have a number that I'm writing in the form of prime factors. And I find that outside the root, I can have 2 into 2 into 2 into 11. And on solving this, I get 88. Next, I have 9604. This can be written as 2 into 2 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. I take the root and I form the pairs and I see that 1, 2, 1, 7 and another 7 can be written out outside the root sign and I'll be left with 2 into 7 into 7, that will give me 98. Next number, again I'm writing in the form of prime factors, taking the root and forming pairs and then taking out one number from each pair out of the root sign and I'll be left with 7 into 11, that will give me 77. Now next, this is what this number can be written in the form of prime factors. I take the square root, I take the pairs again and I see that 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 can be written outside the root sign. On solving, I get 96. Next number I see can be written as 23 into 23. I take the root, form the pairs, take one number out of the pair from the root sign. I'll be left with 23 here. So the root of 529 is 23. Now next number, again I'm taking the prime factors. I take the square root and I'll be left with one pair of 2 and 2 pairs of 3 and one pair of 5 inside the root sign. So when I take one number each out of this root sign, I'll be left with root 8100 equal to 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. I further see that 2 into 3 into 3 into 5 gives me 90. So that's all for now. Thank you very much and all the very best.